A film by Jean Epstein. The Fall of the House of Usher. Based on themes by Edgar Allan Poe. Cast: Marguerite Abel-Gans, Jean Debucourt et Charles Lamy. Cameraman: Lucas. Art Director: Pierre Keffer. Sick and worried. My wife Madeline is dying. And then it will be my turn. I beg you, come to our aid. Roderick Usher. Could one of you drive me to the house of Usher.
Thank you.
this dilapidated mansion, the tyrannical, highly strung Sir Roderick kept his wife Madeline in a state of strange seclusion. Not for all the gold in the world will I drive my horse one step further. The atmosphere of insufferable gloom surrounding the house of Usher seemed supernatural. The physician. The disease of Lady Madeline had long baffled the skill of a physician. By some quirk of heredity, every male descendant of the Usher family devoted himself passionately to painting his wife's portraits. It is there that she lived. Why? You are feverish, my dear Roderick. Ladyship feels weary and begs you to excuse our absence from the table. Once again possessed by a strange and fervid desire to paint, Roderick can think only of being alone with Madeline, his sole model. How is he to rid himself of his intrusive friend? The Usher family tree was as tormented as an old oak and threatened Roderick, the last of the line, with degeneracy. I am by your solicitude, my only friend. But look to your own health too. You would do well to go for a stroll before retiring. Roderick's brush was like a magic wand. With its every stroke, the portrait came more and more to life, but Madeline grew even paler. She seemed to give the painting the strength that was ebbing from her body. this is indeed life itself. Driven by his fascination with mystery, Roderick had long pored over the theories of magnetism. Could be that she is not dead. We shall bury her on this very spot. bid the coffin to be nailed down. Do you hear me?
Thank you.
had been an oppressive silence since Madeline's entombment. The hours and days dragged on and on with harrowing monotony. Almost at breaking point, Roderick seemed to await some sign. The slightest sound exasperated him. Thank you. Roderick dared not repeat the wild conviction that was paralyzing him. Madly. It looked thundery and alive with electricity. There is a double silence. One is the silence of the body. Do not fear it. By some implacable destiny, you should encounter his nameless ghost that haunts desolate regions where no human foot has trod. Commend yourself to God.
Now.
Roderick, you must not behold this. Come, I will read to you and you will listen. Ethelred uplifted his mace outright, and with blows made quickly room in the plankings of the door for his gauntleted hand. And now, pulling therewith sturdily, he so cracked and ripped. And Ethelred uplifted his mace and struck upon the head of the dragon, which fell before him and gave up his pesty breath with a shriek so hurried and harsh and so piercing . Now the champion approached valorously over the silver pavement of the castle to where the shield was upon the wall, which in fact tarried not for his full coming, but fell down at his feet with a mighty great and terrible have heard it long, 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 since the first day.
Thank you.